This Easter, engage in spiritual warfare. Kill the lion and take the honey by the blood of the lamb. A time of spiritual encounter with your host, Dr. Jones Dada Boateng, and special guest speaker, Bishop Abraham Chigbundu.
If you see tonight as a conclusion of this matter, heaven approves it.
In Jesus' name.
Because that is what will push you to pray as though you have never prayed before.
From Friday the 25th of March through to Sunday the 3rd of April, 5 p.m. each night at Deliverance Outreach Ministries, 17 Argyle Avenue, Leighton, London, E107QE. Please call 07950-701-853 or 0207-923-2549 for more details. Be there.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, my dear viewer. This is the Hour of Deliverance. I'm here with Pastor Jonathan again. We're going to agree and pray for you. Something will happen. You will change the level in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you in
Amen.
Jesus' name. Let
Amen.
Your word be quick.
Mm.
Let your word be powerful. Mm. Bring deliverance to your people.
Mm.
Heal your people. Heal
Amen.
The sick.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Last week, we were here talking about repacking of human life by witchcraft.
Mm.
Going back to the original.
Mm.
Changing human destiny.
Mm.
And your story will change forever in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The thing the enemy is using against you is canceled forever.
Amen.
I mean, don't forget our conference, Easter Convention, is coming on. Hallelujah. We have a beautiful, beautiful brochure here. Maybe by next week, we will get a good printing. This is the one that we print from
the first printer.
Our office. So we haven't got the thing very well. But next week, we'll get it very well, and we can bring it to show you. Hallelujah. So don't miss it. Take the details and God will bless you.
Mm.
For your information, I'm coming to Germany. I'll be in Germany from 7th of April. I'll bring the details and we'll put it on your TV so that you can write it. Those of you in Europe, you don't need visa. So far as you're in Europe, you take your car, you are coming. Hallelujah. You are not coming to London. You are coming to Europe. So whether you have your citizenship or no citizenship, if you don't even have paper, take the train, take the bus. I remember when I was using from visa to visa.
Yeah.
I had to take the airport. So I was using the train.
Yes.
From here to Germany was 4 hours.
Mm.
You take the tunnel,
the Eurotunnel.
The Eurostar.
Mm.
2 hours you are in Belgium.
Mm.
45 minutes you are in Cologne.
Mm.
And you can go wherever you are going.
Mm.
2 hours, 45 minutes, you are in Cologne.
Okay,
so it's quite easy. So if you're in Europe, please come. I'm coming to Germany. Call me. I'll give you the details, and God bless you.
Yeah.
I've been talking about repacking on human life.
Mm.
Pastor Joe, let's recap a little bit.
Okay.
Let's read the book of Lamentations chapter 4. Lamentations chapter 4. And today I'm going to show you what happened when human life are repackaging.
Mm.
What happened when human life are repackaged?
Lamentation
chapter
4.
Chapter
4. Verse 1.
Look at verse 1, yes.
How is the gold become dim?
How is the gold become dim?
How is the most fine gold changed?
How is the most fine gold changed?
The stones of the sanctuary are poured out in the top of every street.
Yes.
The precious sons of Zion.
Yes.
Comparable to fine gold.
Yes.
How are they esteemed
mm-hmm.
as extant pictures?
Yes.
The work of the hands of the potter.
That's what we've been talking. And I said last week that one of the area that change human life
mm-hmm.
is the foundation.
The foundation, that's right.
And I said again that what change human life is through your dreams.
Mm.
And I said again that what change human life is through the incisions, the place we visited,
mm.
the thing the witch doctors, satanic agents mm. did for us.
Mm.
Some of you, they take you to the water, they bath you. Some of you, they gave you concussion. Some of you, they gave you charms.
Mm.
Some of you, they gave you incision.
Mm.
Some of you, they put creams on you.
Mm.
Some of us, they have done so many things. I remember when I was back home, I was so sick. My mother thought that I would die. They took me to a village. They call it Sebiakura in Afram Plains.
Yeah.
The woman asked my mother to buy 2 chicken.
Mm.
They used the black one to touch my body.
Mm.
And in my presence, I was about 14 years, Pastor Joe. The chicken died.
Mm.
And they threw the chicken out. They threw the chicken away. We used to play football in Kumasi. And there was a guy called Amufa, very tough guy like this. Yeah. And in Matsiakubu place, Kasi, when we were playing, the guy came and hit my chest. Mm. And from that, begin to develop chest pain. So I went to a friend's place after our vacation, after the school. Mm-hmm. And a man came and tell my mother that, don't you see your son is dying, having these chest pains? They took me to this woman. By taking the chicken to touch my body, a chicken died. Mm. The woman was not holding the chicken on the wings.
Yes.
She was holding the chicken on the leg. And I was not asleep. Mm. I saw it. Chicken touched my body. Within 5 seconds, the chicken died. They threw the chicken, boom, boom, boom. What died in the chicken? My destiny died. Mm. So my destiny was repackaged over there. Mm. So from there, I begin to struggle. Mm. Everything I do don't prosper. Mm. Ministry, you know me, how I work so hard.
That's right.
But Philoa, you cannot confront what you don't know. Mm. It's not about prayer. It's not about knowledge. Jesus said, my people, you know the truth, and the truth you know will set you free. Mm. I have made you free, but you need to be set free.
That's right.
God said in Isaiah, he said, my people, Isaiah 5:13, my people are going to captivity because they lack knowledge, not because of prayer. Mm. My own people, not because the world people, my own people.
Yes.
One of the things that make people's life to be repackaged was by power of spoken word. Mm. You are condemned by your word.
That's right.
You are judged by your words.
That's right.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
So words are very, very powerful. Mm. If you read Genesis 49, Reuben's life was repackaged because the father spoke.
That's right.
I don't know the words your fathers have spoken, but today, by the witness of the blood of Jesus,
amen,
I release your life right now.
In the name of Jesus. God to river.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Many people have, if you get the book, I've put so many times about family altars, the power of spoken word through your dreams, through the wombs, the place that you were born, through incision and blood covenants. I put so many things, the effect of names, our own personal lifestyles. Mm-hmm. It has repackaged so many's life. Mm. I've seen people, a lady came to me going through so many troubles. What happened? Somebody manipulated her to sleep with one man. Mm. And by what she did, now she have HIV. Mm. Now she's looking for prayers. Your own lifestyle. Mm. The doctors will tell you, don't smoke again. That's one smoke will kill you. Mm. But you don't have the willpower to stop it.
Stop it.
Call the number I want to pray for you. Mm. Call it now. 0207-923-2549. Send me only your text message on the mobile phone. Don't call the mobile number. Send only the text message now. Call the two first numbers. And I'm going to read the text message and pray for you. Today I'm talking about what happened when a man's destiny is repackaged.
Mm. What happened?
What happened? What? He said, Ephraim has mixed himself. Ephraim is a cake, not ten.
Right.
Strangers has devoured his strength, and he don't know it. Mm. Gray hair are here.
Yes.
That's the book of Hosea 7:8.
Yes.
Gray hair are here, and you don't know it. So when a destiny is repackaged, what happened? What happened? Mm. Number one, you go to something we call non-achievement. Mm. Are you listening to me? When the original pattern, when the original purpose of God is tempered, you go through what I call unsuccessful in life. Mm. What do I mean by non-achievement? That everything you thought you can, it can't prosper. Mm. This category of people try to do everything, but nothing prosper. Mm. Everybody will sell water, it will prosper. They alone will sell water.
It will not prosper.
No way.
That's right.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
They say, see, I don't know what you're going through. I've counseled so many people to know that this thing I'm talking is real. Mm. I've seen great men, Pastor Joe, great women, but they are pining away in mental home. Mm. God didn't create anybody to be a mental patient.
That's right.
But people are made to be mental patient because their original
has been repackaged. Yeah. Something has gone wrong.
Something has gone wrong. When I was coming, I was talking to a dear lady who was telling me that how she's been listening to me and how when she was in school at the age of 14 years, a dog bit her. Mm. And the mother took her to a witch doctor. They gave her incision. And up to today, married, no baby. Mm. Clever woman. Mm. One of the greatest women I've ever met. Mm. But no baby. Why? It didn't start from now. No, she was repackaged when they give her that incision through the dog bite.
It was only a matter of time.
Are you listening to me? Number two, you go through what I call poverty.
That's right.
Poverty is a spirit.
Oh, yes.
It's not because you don't work hard. Because if you read the Bible, now let's read this thing. Let's read this thing quickly. Go to the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 3. Look at Genesis chapter 3. Hallelujah. Yeah. Genesis chapter 3. Mm-hmm. Let's read from verse 17.
Genesis 3, 17.
Thank you, Jesus.
And unto Adam he said.
And unto Adam he said.
Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife.
Yes, sir.
And hast eaten of the tree.
Yes,
of
sir.
Which I commanded thee, saying.
Yes, sir.
Thou shalt not eat of it.
Yes, sir.
Cursed is the ground for thy sake.
Curse is the ground for your sake. Because of you, the ground is cursed.
Yes.
And look at the next one. Whatever you planted, it
and
will not yield.
And shalt thou eat of it all the days of your life.
Keep going.
Thorns also
Tons and thistles
shall it bring forth to thee.
Keep going.
And thou shalt eat the herb of the field.
Keep going.
In the sweat
in
of
the
thy face
of thy
shalt
face.
Thou eat bread.
Did you hear that?
Thou return unto the ground.
Did you hear that?
For out of it was thou taken.
Did you hear that? Thank yes, you. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Poverty. That's why one of the curses Jesus break
is poverty.
Is poverty.
Yes.
He sweats. Mm. He said, you will eat from their sweat. Mm. Bible said they put the thorns on his head to break poverty.
Yes.
Bible said Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, his sweat changed to become blood.
That's right.
By the, he said, I have come. Let's read this one. In the book of Luke. Luke chapter 4. Look at verse 18.
Luke 4:18.
Yes, sir.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Yes.
Because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor.
Did you hear that? His first message means poor people, I'm here to break poverty from
That's
you.
Right.
Poverty is a spirit.
It is, yes.
How did he came? When a man's life is repackaging, the first thing that happened to that man is poverty.
It's poverty.
I asked you to read some passage the other day. Let's read it again. In the book of John, chapter 5. In the book of John, chapter 5.
Yes.
John let's 5. Read from the verse 4. John 5, verse 4.
And a certain man was there.
A certain man was there.
Which had an infirmity 38 years.
38 years.
When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now
a long
time in that case, he said unto him, Will thou be made whole? The impotent man answered him, Sir, I have no man.
Did you hear that? Thank
when
you.
The water is troubled.
Thank you, Pastor Joe. Now. He said, a certain man who has been sick. They didn't say a certain boy who has been sick for 38 years. If you are a man and you have been sick for 38 years, let's imagine this man was 30 years and has been sick for 38 years. Join it together.
So 68.
68. When are you going to work to achieve?
That's right.
How can, that's why the man said, I have no man. Because a poor man has no friend.
That's right.
Call the number, I want to pray for you. When a man is going through repackaging of human life, you became useless.
That's right.
Are you sitting? When that's what I said, this is a phone.
Yeah.
But I can't use it to ring. Because I've removed the chip here and I put the same chip here. It's EE phone.
Yes.
It's EE chip.
That's right.
One-to-one. So I can put it here, I can put it here. It's the same phone, but this one is unusable. This one is usable.
Because of the chip.
Because of the chip. So when a man potential is tempered with, when your original is tempered with, you become useless.
That's right.
That's why God said, the Bible said, he that find a wife has found a good thing. Not a woman. You can find a woman, but you never have a wife. You can have a man, but you never have a husband.
That's right.
The fact that they are men does not mean that they can be a husband.
That's right.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
So a wife is different from a woman.
Oh, yes.
A wife is a thing you must desire to find, not a woman, though they are women.
Yes. Because you have to make a wife out of a woman.
That's it. He that find a wife find a good thing.
That's right.
A good thing is a substance, it's a matter.
Something with value.
Something with value.
That's right.
You must find it. That's find it. Right. Pray for it.
That's right. Work hard for it.
Work hard for it. So when a man's destiny is repackaged, you go through what I call struggling. You struggle to do everything in life. Mm. You struggle in ministry. Mm. When people begin to come, you won't do them anything. They just left and go.
That's right.
It's like everything you do is struggling. Mm. You ask yourself question, what can I do again? You struggle to get a job. You struggle to get married. Mm. You struggle to do everything. Mm. In your dream, even you struggle to sleep. Mm. Dogs, chain, cars. It's like you ask yourself question, what again? You struggle to maintain a car. Every day, another problem to another problem. Yes, everything you do is struggling. Mm. I pray for you.
In the name of Jesus.
From today, whatever make Jesus. You to struggle,
yes.
By the voice in the blood of Jesus,
amen.
By the witness in the blood of
amen.
Jesus, by the spirit of grace,
amen.
By the spirit of prophecy,
amen.
I release you in the name of Jesus. One of the things I love so much is Revelation chapter 1, verse 5.
Mm-hmm.
It says, Jesus, who was the faithful, who is the faithful witness
mm-hmm.
of whatever happened
mm-hmm.
about the blood.
Yes.
So whatever you are going through, are you listening to me? The blood is powerful to deal with it.
Oh, yes.
So I'm praying for you
mm.
by the witness of the blood,
amen.
By the faithful witness
mm.
from the person in the blood,
mm.
I declare in the name of Jesus,
mm-hmm.
I release you,
mm.
I release you,
yeah.
I release yeah, you in yeah. Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You cannot be greater than what is in you.
Yes.
It's what in you that make you greater.
It's true.
The blood is inside you.
Mm.
Jesus is inside you.
Inside you
you right. can't be poor again.
That's right.
Are you listening? He said, the spirit of the Lord God is upon me,
mm.
for he has sent me to preach the gospel to the poor. I don't know what is making you to mm. struggle in life,
mm.
but hear this today.
Mm.
Today, by the remitting blood,
amen.
By the atonement blood,
amen.
By the spirit of God,
amen.
I release you in Jesus'
name.
In the
name of Jesus.
See, one of the things that happen to people
mm.
when their life is repackaged, is that they have ideas, they have vision, but they can't put it to paper. Mm. They have visions,
yes,
they have dreams,
yes.
they have ideas, mm. but nobody buy that idea.
No.
And it frustrates them.
Mm.
It frustrates them.
Amen.
When you have idea, you know that you do this. The lady that gave me idea to write books,
yes.
he came there and showed me his paper.
Yes.
His book that he has tried to
yeah,
write,
yes.
it's on the paper.
Mm.
I listen to me. We have written how many now? Almost to 70 now.
Mm.
I've lost count.
Mm.
I listen to me. Yeah. But the book the woman is trying to write is still there. Mm. I listen to me. Yeah, because they know that if they allow this woman to write this book,
that's right.
something can happen to her.
Mm.
There was a young man, let me tell you a story. There was a young man that was going through poverty. And he has written one book. Even the first 500 copies, he couldn't sell 50 from that book.
Mm.
So one day, a powerful man of God got hold of one of his books. And he read it, and that book is powerful. He called the man. He said, I'm Pastor so-and-so, so-and-so. I just read your book, and how many do you have? He said, oh, how many copies do you have? He says, I wrote it about 20 years ago, and 500 copies. I couldn't sell in 50 copies, so I have about 400 copies there.
Mm.
He said, no, I need 1 million copies. Ah! The man said, okay, I'm going to give it to my partners.
Mm-hmm.
And how much will you give it to me? The man said, I'll give it to you for $5. The man said, okay. Because one book will cost him about $2.
Yes.
And the man said, I need 1 million copies. Mm-hmm. You don't have it, I'll print it. Within 1 month, the man sold over 1.5 million copies.
Mm.
A non-entity has become a millionaire.
It's true.
If they did it for you, £2, $2,
yeah.
and you sell it $3, you have $3 million in profit.
That is it.
See, why the enemy don't, you have vision,
it's
but
true.
The enemy don't want you to do it that.
Mm.
They know that it's going to change your life.
Mm.
But your life has been already tempered with. What in you control you?
Hmm.
In the book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 12, he said, and the spirit driveth him.
That's right.
So what it is what in you that drive you.
That's right.
The spirit driveth him.
That's right.
I'm talking about repackaging of human life. Mm. How the goal change? Mm. Why are you barren? Mm. Why can't you marry? Mm. Why are you going through miscarriages? Mm. Why are you going through frustration? Yeah. Why are you going through poverty? Yes. Why are you going through non-achievement? Mm. Why you rise today, you fall tomorrow? That's what is making you to go through this frustration? Mm. Nothing destroys man than ignorance. Mm. Call the number quickly. I want to pray for you. Call it now. Call it now. Mm. Send me your test message quickly. I want to pray for you. Are you listening to me? I want to pray for you. So many people are sending their text messages. Look at this text message that somebody just sent. Pastor, I have dream. I have dreams all kinds. My son going through a mess. Mm. Things are going through mess in my house. Mm. Please pray for me. Mm. I dream seeing cats and dogs and all over. Mm. Pastor Joe, stretch your hand and pray for
Father,
this.
Father, I pray for this dear one. Mm. Whatever is going wrong in your house, we come against it in the name of Jesus. Mm. Whatever was introduced into your house for failure through dreams, we break it by the blood of Jesus, the blood that brings mercy and grace. Mm. May you receive it and may your house turn around for the glory of God. Mm. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Pastor, could you pray for me? I'm going partial blindness. My name is Mavis, M-A-V-I-S.
That's right.
Mavis, thank you. May God bless you. I pray for you.
In the name of
that
Jesus.
Spirit of blindness is canceled.
Amen.
I release you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, Pastor. Could you pray for me? I'm also going through everything you are saying. It's like you are preaching my story. Please pray for me. Hiya. I agree, I declare, whatever is happening to you, it is canceled. In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
Your story has changed.
Amen.
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 Dear men of God, please agree with me and pray for me.
Mm.
I can't remember my dreams.
Mm.
And please, give me a hint how I can remember my dreams. Pastor Joe, please pray for this wonderful lady and
Father,
give her a hint.
Father, we pray for her. Whatever happens in her dream for evil that she doesn't even remember, Father, we cancel it by the blood of Jesus. Father, you spoke to your men through dreams. You revealed many mysteries to your people through dreams. Father, whatever the enemy is using as a channel to destroy her life, we destroy it in the name of Jesus. By your blood, we are causing a turnaround. By your mercy and your grace, we are calling a turnaround. May her life turn around for the better, for your own glory and honor. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah. Listen, another dream, another message has come again. Please pray for me. I am in debt, too much in debt. I cannot pay even my rent. And I'm not working. Please agree and pray for me. I agree and pray for you. Whatever is bringing this unusual debt, it is canceled. By the blood of Jesus, by the anointing of God, by the finger of God, I release you in Jesus' name. Hello, Pastor, please pray for my health. I've been sick from the whole last year, February, until now. And the doctors can't locate my sickness. My relationship is suffering because of this. You see there?
That's right.
Sick the whole last year.
That's right.
The doctors can't find anything. I release you from this sickness. Amen. Listen here. We want to go to quick break. We are doing a powerful conference in this April. I call it Easter Convention. Our spiritual father is coming all the way from Nigeria.
March to April.
Yeah. We are starting 25th of March,
that's right,
which is a Good Friday, all the way to the following Sunday, which is 3rd of April. From 25th all the way to 3rd, 10 powerful days, is fasting and praying, using the blood of Jesus to kill the lion and take the honey. God gave me this revelation. When Samson, in Samson's family, there was a pattern there. Nobody can cross the border of Timnah. And Bible said when Samson got there, the lion roared against him. Now, why couldn't the lion roar against the mother or against the father? Because they have finished the old stuff. You are the new one. We must stop you. But the Spirit of God came on Samson, and he used bare hand to sear the lion. And inside the lion was the honey. And Samson got it. So I want you to take details from this advert. And call me and let us know that you are coming. And God will bless you in Jesus' name. Before we go, want Pastor Joe, we are not going, we are just having a short break. But Pastor Joe, give your number. If somebody wants to call, they can call you and then we pray for them.
Okay, my number is on the screen.
Yes,
House
sir.
Of God Ministry.
Yes, sir.
We are in Feltham.
Yes, sir.
The number to get me is 07969
yes, sir.
553068.
Repeat it again to them.
I'll repeat the number. 07-969-553-068.
Hallelujah.
You know, I am there Monday to Wednesday, 10 o'clock to 6 o'clock, just praying with people. You know, there are certain things Jesus told his disciples, this cannot go except by prayer
and fasting.
Yes, sir. Though Jesus has given them authority.
Yes, sir.
You know, so there are certain things, it cannot go by one prayer, two prayer, you know. When Paul was going through his thorn in the flesh, he went to God about three times and said, my grace is sufficient for
Hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah.
You know, there are certain things, it is only by grace.
Yes,
I've given you the grace to go through. Whatever you are going through, God has provided the grace. Without challenges, there is no miracle.
Yes, sir.
Without sin, there is no mercy.
Yes, sir.
So the more your challenges come, that is opportunity to tell you
yes,
there is a miracle.
Yes, sir.
So you soak yourself in
yes,
prayer.
Sir. Yes, sir.
We don't fully understand the power of prayer.
Yes, sir.
Jesus wouldn't have left the disciples
yes, sir.
And go into the mountain,
on the mountain
and pray
yes,
uninterruptedly. My brother, my sister, there is a remedy. Don't be lazy. If you stop certain things that you are doing, you have time to go through.
Hallelujah.
Though you have been testing, I am going through this, I'm going through this. We cannot wave a magic on you, but sometimes it needs your commitment. Grace comes by our commitment. Grace, you cannot receive it anyhow. Yes, this is a free gift, but you have to make a move to get it. The move is your faith, and your faith will let you receive the grace of God. Don't sit there and suffer. Don't let God go through pain, because he is in you. So when you are suffering, God is also suffering.
When you are feeling, God is suffering.
You are failing God through your problem. You are allowing the enemy to take the upper hand. He said, when you pray, say, your kingdom come.
Yes, sir.
So his kingdom is for his prosperity,
yes, sir.
For things to go well.
Yes, sir.
So if you are in your sickness, in your poverty, the kingdom of God is not coming.
No, we
are not praying that prayer of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to go to a quick break. Please take the numbers and start calling now, and your power will change and God will bless you. Don't forget that if you send us 20 pounds or more, I'll give you these four books. Hallelujah. This is a three, and I'll add this one that I'm preaching from Turret. And God will bless you in Jesus' name. Any check you are making, make it payable to Deliverance Outreach Ministry. This is one of my latest books, very, very powerful book. I'm going to add it to you. Read it. You'll know. What do I mean by the mystery of God's last card? What do I mean by that? Hallelujah. It's all inside the book. You must get it, and God will bless you. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Please don't go anywhere. We want to go to a short break. The moment we finish the advert, I'm coming back again. Take my details, take the telephone number, take everything. Go to my website, www.domlive.org. Everything you are looking for, the radio is there. My email is reverendboati@yahoo.co.uk. Send me your text message or whatever. Go to the email. Do something. Just like Pastor Jonathan said, don't sit down and die. There's a remedy for you. Are you listening to me? May God bless you. I will see you. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
This Easter, engage in spiritual warfare. Kill the lion and take the honey by the blood of the Lamb. A time of spiritual encounter with your host, Dr. Jones Dada Boateng, and special guest speaker, Bishop Abraham Chigbundu.
If you see tonight as a conclusion of this matter, heaven approves it.
In Jesus' name.
Because that is what will push you to pray as though you have never prayed before.
From Friday the 25th of March through to Sunday the 3rd of April, 5 p.m. each night at Deliverance Outreach Ministries, 17 Argyle Avenue, Leighton, London, E107QE. Please call 07950-701-853 or 0207-923-2549 for more details. Be there.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, my dear viewer. This is the Hour of Deliverance. My name is Pastor Jones Dada Boateng from Deliverance Outreach Ministry. My prayer is that God will touch you, God will bless you, God will lift you on high in Jesus' mighty name. I'm here with Pastor Jonathan. We're going to agree and pray for you. Something will happen to you in Jesus' name. We've been talking about repackaging of human life by witchcraft, or how the enemy changed human life. How many destiny has been tempered with. How many people are not where they're supposed to be. How many people life in tatters? Great men that are supposed to be at the top are behind. Mm. Great women that are supposed to enjoy fantastic marriage are now going through marital turbulence. Mm-hmm. Women that are supposed to give birth to professors now barren. Mm. Women are going through menstrual pain, abnormal menstruation. Mm. I want to pray for you. Mm. Are you listening to me? A lady came to our church and was saying something to me. Pastor Joe, I haven't heard this one. That anytime she slept with her husband, she felt boils all over her private part. Pain. Mm. Pain. Mm. Why? Is that
the plan of the enemy?
Is that God created? Mm. He said, when my husband is sleeping with me, it's tears. Mm. Cry. I had a baby. Mm. We have three babies. Mm. But daddy, I can't stand it again. Mm. I was even telling my husband, go out and find somebody. That's not how God created it. Mm. How? The precious sons of Zion, comparable to fine gold, why have they exchanged like this? Mm. Look at this quotation that I always read it. It's very, very fantastic. In Isaiah 26, mm-hmm. Look at verse 13. Isaiah 26, verse 13. I love this quotation. I read it. He said what?
Isaiah 26.
26. Look at verse 13. Let's start from there now. And I'm going to give you this thing quickly. Please, my number is on your TV now. I want you to take your telephone, call that number, send me text messages. I'm going to pray for you. One thing about prayer is that, like Pastor Jonathan was explaining, there are certain things it can't go except by prayer and fasting. Yes. And what Jesus said in Matthew 18, verse 19, is that whatsoever two will agree, yes, anything in touching on this earth, mm, it shall be done by the Father. Yes. Agreement is powerful. Yes. We want to agree with you, mm, and pray with you. Amen. And whatever the enemy is holding you, mm, it will be destroyed. Mm. What the Bible said?
Isaiah 26, 13.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord our God.
Yes.
Other laws beside thee have had dominion over us.
Did you hear that?
That's right.
Other God beside you has had dominion over us, mm, but
by thee only, mm-hmm, will we make mention of thy name.
Look at this controversial quotation.
Yes.
Other, you go home, you see your beautiful wife, mm-hmm, there, and your wife tell you that, Pastor Jonathan, other men, mm-hmm, are sleeping with me, mm-hmm, but you are my husband.
Yes.
Will you agree?
Not at all.
The same thing that is happening. Right. So something has tempered with our destiny, mm, before we became born again. And I said to you the other day that what makes our destiny to be tempered with is through the thing that enter us.
Yes.
What enter you control you. Mm. Jesus, when he was going, he said, drink it, this is my blood. Mm. If you don't drink it, then my spirit is not in you.
In you,
so
right,
when you see somebody misbehaving, mm, awkwardly, mm, you know that something has taken charge of the body.
Right.
I said to you that spoken word, mm-hmm, can change a man's destiny.
Yes.
I spoke with you the other day that the witch doctors we visited, the incision they gave to us,
yes,
the concoction, the,
yes,
charms,
yeah,
can temper, can change our destiny,
right,
can repackage our life.
That's right.
I said to you that your mother's womb, most of us, especially, yes, from Africa, yes, when our mother conceived, mm, when our mother was looking for babies,
yes,
they go through so many places. Mm. And the places they went to, they gave them something.
Something,
and
right,
the baby was contaminated in the womb.
Mm, that's right.
So many things. If you read a book, I put so many things over there. Are you listening to me? Mm. Your dreams, your wombs, your place of birth, your date of birth, covenant, incisions, your own personal behavior, the name they gave to you can even, yeah, repackage your life. Mm. They wanted to give John the Baptist, Zachariah.
Yes.
The mother said, not so.
Yeah.
Why? Because Zachariah have had that name for, mm, years, couldn't perform. Mm. Jabez was repackaged because of a name. Mm. The mother was going through sorrow, mm, and the mother gave the name Sorrow. Mm. And his name repackaged his life.
That's right.
Look at Benjamin. The father, thank God the father was there.
Yes.
And the father said, no, he will not be called Ben-Onin.
That's
because,
right,
of the pain the mother was going through.
That's
Bible,
right,
said, when Rachel was giving birth to her, mm, her soul was sore, mm, and her soul was departing. Mm. And they said, no, woman of woman, you have had a son again. Mm. He said, no, his name will be called Ben-Onin, mm, the son of my sorrow. Mm. Thank God the father was there. And the father said, no, his name will be called Benjamin, mm, the son of my right hand.
That's right.
Many people, our name has repackaged us. Mm. That's why Bible says a good name must be chosen. A good name is better than ointment. Mm. If you read the Bible, the name Job means he cried.
Yes.
And look at Job, how he cried.
Yes.
The name Joseph means he had. Mm. And God used Joseph to ensure the multiplication of Israel. Mm. Abraham's former name was called Azum, father.
Yeah.
And God must change it to become the father of many nations.
That's right.
So names are very important.
Are
you listening to me? Yes. Names. Adam's name. Adam means coming out of the soil. Mm. Adam. Mm. And if you look at how God was explaining his background, he said, you come from the earth and death, and earth you should go.
That's right.
So a name works for people. A name. Most of the angels that we know their name, God named them after him.
That's
Michael.
Right. Yes.
Gabriel.
That's right.
El means God.
That's right.
I don't know your name. I'm just talking. Look at the meaning of your name.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Mm. And I've been talking about what happened to you when your life is repackaged.
Mm.
I said to you, you go through non-achievement.
That's right.
I said to you, you go through non-status.
Mm.
I said to you, you go through people have vision and dreamers. Mm. But you can't use it.
Mm.
You go through struggling.
Mm.
You go through rise and fall.
Mm.
One of the things I didn't tell you is that you go through attacks. Because when your life is repackaging, something that repackage you maintain that you will go through that repackaging.
Mm.
It's like Pastor Joe will call me. Pastor Dada, I've heard your message. I want to help you. Come and take this 10,000 for your ministry. By the time I get there, something will even attack you.
Yes, sir.
They can attack your business.
Mm.
You say, reach there at 5 o'clock. By the time I'm coming there, my car will spoil. Something, it's like attack.
Yes.
See, when you begin to go through one attack from attack, you know that something's behind it.
Something is stopping you. That's right.
Look at your dream, how you've been attacked.
Mm.
A young man came to our church, have a big scar over here.
Mm.
And I asked there, what happened here? He said, Daddy, I was driving. I saw a big bear from nowhere hit my car. Boom. And all I know is that I was in a hospital, intensive care unit.
Mm.
Who brought the bed there? See, people are going through crisis, pain, attacks in their dreams, physically. They can't sleep. Call the number, send me text message quickly. I want to pray for you. Mm. I don't know the attacks over you. Mm. There are certain people, Pastor Joe, they can't even sleep.
Yes.
There are certain people, they can't do anything.
Oh, yes.
Are you listening to me? He said, oh, Lord, our God, other gods beside you have had dominion over us. But your name.
Will we make mention of thy name?
Look at the quotation that you read. John. Let's read John chapter 5 quickly because we have very few minutes to go now. John chapter 5. Let's read from verse 5.
John chapter 5, verse 5.
Mm-hmm. Or let's read it from verse 4.
For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water.
Mm.
Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there.
Now, you continue. He said what? A certain man. What is his name? When a man's destiny is tempered with, repackaged, he don't have a name. A certain man has been there 38 years. Nobody know his name. Obviously, when this man was born, their father gave him a name.
That's right.
So one thing I put in my book is that when a man's destiny is repackaged or when your destiny is tempered with, you don't have a name.
Yes.
Nobody regards you.
Your name is forgotten.
Are you listening to me? Everything, I put something that when a man is repackaged, you achieve and you lose it. He said, I have no man. Everything this man has achieved, he has lost it. In the book, if you read the book of Mark, Bible said there was a woman there who have issue of blood. Mark chapter 5. Yeah. If you read verse 21, he said he has lost everything.
She had.
Do you have Mark there?
Yeah. On the doctors.
She has lost everything. She achieved it, but she has lost it.
That's right.
That's what is happening to many people.
Even if she works, it goes into the
They doctor. Buy mortgage, but they lose it.
Mm.
They marry, they lose it. They get pregnant, all right, they lose it. Are you there? Look at verse 21.
Okay. And when Jesus was passed over again by ship unto the other side, Much people gathered unto him.
Yes.
And he was nigh unto the sea.
Yes.
And behold, there cometh one of the rulers of the synagogue, yes. Jairus by name.
Yes.
And when he saw him, he fell at his feet and besought him greatly, saying, My little daughter lieth at the point of death. I pray thee, come and lay thy hands on her, that she may be healed, and she shall live.
Keep going.
And Jesus went with him.
Yes.
And much people followed him.
Keep going.
And thronged him.
Yes.
And a certain woman, which had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had.
Did you hear that?
And was nothing better.
Everything that she achieved, she lost it. That's what I call achieve and lose syndrome. They don't care if you achieve it, but you must lose it. A certain woman, what was his name? Do you think that, Pastor Joe, you have issue of blood for 12 years, you can marry again? Or can you have a husband whilst you are bleeding, hemorrhaging for 12 years?
No.
The lady formerly, maybe she was a rich person.
Yes.
Because during that time, if you are not wealthy, you don't go to physicians.
Yes.
Because physicians were not many like our time.
They would charge money.
They would charge money. And that's why Bible says she has lost everything. So when a woman's destiny is tempered, you achieve, you lose it. One of the things that I put in my book here is that when a woman's destiny is repackaged, you are delaying of destiny fulfillment. This woman was supposed to marry maybe 30 years. And she has been hemorrhaging for another 12 years, 42 years. When is she going to have babies?
That's right.
When is she going to marry? Thank God Jesus healed her.
Time, yes.
But her destiny is gone. I look at the man in John chapter 5.
Yes.
Thank God Jesus healed him.
Yes.
Everybody was happy.
Yes.
But 38 years in sickness. If he was 30 years, and has been sick for another 38 years, 68 years. When is he going to marry?
That's right.
When is he going to work?
You lost time.
Your destiny is delayed.
That's right.
And when you are delayed, you are denied. And when you are denied, you are useless.
That's right.
That's why you see people frustrating in life because they are being delayed. It's like last week I went to this driver's school or whatever, and they said what makes a man to go over speed is frustration.
That's right, it's true.
Because you sat in the traffic, and when the traffic eases, and that's why they put restriction. Because you are frustrated in life, so everything, you want to do it quick, and by the time you make mistakes.
You want to catch up.
Catch up, that's the word. I pray for you. Everything that has delayed you, deny you,
yes, Lord.
By the blood of Jesus,
yes, Lord.
It is canceled.
Canceled.
Whatever tempered with your destiny,
oh, yes, Lord.
Any altar that has caged your destiny,
yes, Lord.
Any witch that has caged your destiny,
yes, Lord.
By the remitting blood,
oh, yes.
By the voice of the blood,
yes, Lord.
By the evidence of the blood,
yes,
of Jesus,
Lord.
By the atonement blood,
yes, Lord.
I release you in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I listen to him.
Amen.
One of the things that happened when a person destiny is tempered with is denial of destiny fulfillment. You are denied. See, imagine this young man, supposed to be a businessman, supposed to marry. At the age of 65 years, 68 years, would you give your beautiful daughter to him to marry?
No.
You are gone.
Yeah.
At least when Jesus healed him at the age of 68 years, you must get a little bit strength.
Yes.
Number two, you must find job. Number three, you must have some money before you can marry. By the time all these things are done, the man will be about 75 years. At the age of 75 years, if you are 75 years, all the women you must marry, from about 45, 50. Even 50 years, 75 years is too much.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? It's me going to marry a 25-year-old girl.
No.
It's too much.
Yes.
So at 75 years, you can't get a woman to marry that will give you babies.
That's true.
Except a miracle. Except you are wealthy. Because in Africa, you see wealthy men at the age of 80 years, 90 years, married 25 years.
Yes.
Because of money.
Yes.
Are you listening to me? And somebody that has been sick for 38 years, your destiny has been denied. There's a destiny delayed. There's a destiny denied.
That's right.
Are you listening to me? And when your destiny is denied, your destiny is derailed. Mm-hmm. Derailed means you are out of course.
That's right.
I put it over there. Your destiny can be derailed. When the train is going, a train is not supposed to go on the main ground.
Yes.
A train has a special rail.
That's
so
right.
When a train struck mm-hmm. or a train misses track, mm-hmm. it's stacked. When you are derailed, you are stacked. That's you can't move again.
You can't move.
And many people are stagnated, stuck in life.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Mm.
One of the things I put in my book, I said, diversion of or deviation of original plan of God when your destiny is gone. You're supposed to go here. But see, this man, when he come out of this prison,
yes.
somebody is 25 years. Something happened. You stab somebody. Mm. They put you in jail life. Life is 25 years. Spend 25 years and you come. Your destiny is gone.
It's true.
You come out. What is your destiny again? Are you listening to me? People are going through pain.
Mm.
I met a young girl in Arizona. I was doing a crusade, and when we were preaching, the girl was having phone on his ear and was talking and talking and talking and talking and talking. So after we finished, I asked her, "What? We are preaching and you are talking?" He said, "No. I just come from prison. My brother is in prison. Mm. My mother, six children, all of us are in prison.
Mm.
And when you were preaching, he was also hearing.
Mm.
And we were praying together."
That's right.
I said, "Sit down, let's talk."
That's right.
He said, "Daddy, we don't know." He called me Daddy. "We don't know. Something came on us like blackout.
Mm.
By the time we came back ourselves, we have killed somebody."
Mm.
He said, "My own, I just stabbed the person, and thank God the person didn't die."
Mm.
I listened to me. And that's why I went in for 10 years, spent 8 years, I think 6 years or something, and came with a tag on the leg that if he don't behave good, he'll go back there again.
Mm.
Why? If it's her alone, we can say that it is her character. Mm. Six of them, all of them are in prison.
Mm.
Are you listening to me? When a man original is changed, his place in life becomes vacant.
That's right.
Somebody take your spot.
Mm.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Your identity is changed. They say a woman have issue of blood.
Mm.
A man who has been sick, what is your name? Everybody know that your name is Pastor Jonathan.
That's right.
What makes people to call you that pastor? Because there is a wrong thing about you.
Yes.
That pastor abused me.
Mm. Yeah.
He's so angry, he don't want to mention your name.
Yes.
We want to pray for you.
Mm.
We have a few minutes to go. Hallelujah. People, text message are coming very thick and fast. And I want to pray for you. Keep sending your text message. You hear me? Keep sending your text messages. And I want to pray for you. Hallelujah. Please pray for the Lord to establish my business and break the spirit of poverty from my life. Pastor Joe, stretch your hand on this camera and break
Father,
the spirit
I
of
pray
poverty.
For this dear one.
Mm.
She has asked for prayer. We stand in the gap and we pray for her.
Mm-hmm.
That, oh Lord, you will establish her business. We come against anything that want to repackage her business and her life.
Mm.
We break you in the name of Jesus. Let the business be fruitful and replenish in the name of Jesus.
Please pray for me from all forms of setbacks, barrenness, disappointment, lack, and every force that has been assigned to hold my life. Today, let it be destroyed. My name is Blessing. Pray for God to remove demonic altars, generational curses, and evil eye following me. Lord, I pray.
Amen.
I declare setbacks is broken.
Amen.
Barrenness is broken.
Amen.
Whatever your fathers planted in your house, generational curses, I declare it is broken forever.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Sir, hope you are well. My name is Kumoto. I've been unemployed for 10 months.
Mm.
Please pray for me. I can't even get a job. And my mortgage is at stake. I'm increasingly becoming desperate. Oh, Pastor Joe, please pray for Kumoto.
Father, I pray for this dear one, wherever she is or he is. Father, I pray. Let job locate her.
Mm.
Whatever is fighting against her job, unemployed for 10 months, oh Lord, that is not your plan for their life. I come against every plan of the enemy who wants you to suffer and even lose your mortgage. We break their hold in the name of Jesus. We release you. Let job find you. Get a job that will help you to settle and see the glory of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. I have this one here. My name is Mr. Pandi Raju, isn't it? Pandi Raju.
Yeah, my name is Pandi Raju.
He said he's going through what? Read it for.
I am suffering from depression and I got demons inside me.
Hey,
could you please pray for me? Thanks.
I agree with you. Any demonic spirit inside you, I cast them in Jesus' name. Your body is not your house. I command them to let you go now in Jesus' name. May God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Hello, sir. Please pray for me. I am in spiritual prison and I can't do anything. Agree and pray for me. Pastor Joe, pray for this lady to be released.
Father, we pray. The same angel that released Peter, may he also release you from that prison, that spiritual bondage. We break every chain. We break every door. We break every bar that is holding you captive. Be released by the Spirit of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Look at this one. Pastor, come to my rescue. Come to my rescue.
Yes,
I am fighting to achieve my daily bread. Look at that.
Yes.
My daily bread. Just when things are getting better, then came problems. My name is Austin. Austin, I pray for you. Anything making you to become this, I declare it is canceled.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Whatever has repackaged your life, I declare it is canceled.
It's canceled.
By the blood of Jesus.
By the blood of Jesus.
I release you right now.
I release.
Please pray for me. I don't have a job. Pastor Joe, please pray for my
Father,
brother.
Father, I pray for this dear one. There is nobody looking for a job that will not have a job. But Father, for this dear one, we come against the plan of the enemy to frustrate them and to bring them low. So I come against that spirit, taking your job away from you, making you unemployable. I break that yoke and I release you. May a job find you so that you will testify of the goodness of the Lord for his own glory and honor. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
Matilda, I pray for you. You also said you are looking for marriage. There's no marriage in my family. Matilda, I pray for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Pastor, I always dream and see dead people, and I see myself eating. I declare it is canceled in Jesus' name. Pastor, please pray for me. My husband and I, we are suffering from loss of pregnancy. We have had 16 miscarriages. When I was 17 years, I turned into blue, and my mother took me to a witch doctor. After doing so many things, I became well. And I think that because of that, I'm going through what I'm going through. 16 miscarriages. Many pregnancy losses. 16 miscarriages. Aish. All right. May God give you your heart desire in Jesus' name. I tell you, I'm preaching from this, my book here. It's a very, very powerful book. One of my powerful books. I wrote it. And God will bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, sorry. Something is holding my distance. I pray something over there. And okay. Hallelujah. Listen to me. I want to give you this, my book. I want to add this, my new book to it. And I want to add this one to it. And I want to add this one to it. Four books. If you can help our ministry, £20 or more, I will send you this book. Hallelujah. It's books that I recommend for everybody. And it will bless you. My number is 0795070853. The other numbers are 0207923-2549. Don't forget our Easter convention and Papa Mu. I'll be in Germany in April 7th. So don't forget it and follow our ministry and God will bless you in Jesus' name. If you make a check, make it payable to Deliverance Outreach Ministry or put something in an envelope and send it to us and God will bless you. Please don't sit down. There's something God has given to you and it will help you.
Amen.
Get this book. It will benefit you.
Amen.
Amen. Pastor Joe, give your number before we go,
okay,
please.
Okay, my number is on the screen or it will appear soon. House of God Ministry, we are in Feltham and take this number and call me anytime and I'll pray with you. 07-969-553068. Repeat the number 07-969-553068. The Lord is with you.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is always ready to deliver his people.
Hallelujah.
He wouldn't have sent his son to come and share his blood.
Hallelujah.
He wouldn't have sent his son to come and die such a gruesome death.
Hallelujah.
He wouldn't have allowed his son to be naked on the cross so that your poverty will turn into richness, so that your sickness will turn into good health. It is my prayer that his mercy and grace will locate you, that your life will be transformed. Don't sit there and suffer.
Hallelujah.
If the enemy has brought thorn in your flesh, call on this number and we'll pray for you.
Hallelujah.
May the Lord be merciful to you.
Amen. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Listen to me. I said to you that if you're making a check, make it payable to Deliverance Outreach Ministry. Take my address and send us something. These people have been here preaching to us. To come on the TV 1 hour, 30 minutes is not easy. It takes money to come here. So help us and God will help you. One of the things that makes God to bless people is the people that give to his ministry. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. And all these other things people are dying for will be added unto you.
Amen.
I want you to help us and God will help you. May God bless you. May God empower you. May God lift you on high. Whatever you are looking for, receive it in Jesus' name. Every form of depression, every oppression, every suppression, I declare it is canceled in Jesus' name.
Amen.
By the Spirit of God, every barrenness, depression, rejection, defeat, miscarriages, untimely death, delayance in marriage, premature death, hereditary disease, I declare it is canceled. That migraine, I cancel it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Spirit of fear, anxiety, I cancel it in Jesus'
name. Jesus.
Nightmares, attacks in your dreams, financial attacks, I destroy it in Jesus'
name.
Any family breakdown, marital depression, marital disorder, turbulence in your marriage, I declare it is canceled. That poverty and stagnation, I declare it's canceled.
Amen.
That incurable disease, I declare it is canceled.
Amen.
Whatever is bringing shame and disgrace, I declare it is canceled. Be blessed in the name of Jesus. Receive power in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Myself and Pastor Jonathan said, God bless you.
God bless you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. And God bless
it you. It is well with you.
Bye. God bless
Bye-bye.
You. Bye.
This Easter, engage in spiritual warfare. Kill the lion and take the honey by the blood of the Lamb. A time of spiritual encounter with your host, Dr. Jones Dada Boateng, and special guest speaker, Bishop Abraham Chigbundu.
If you see tonight as a conclusion of this matter, heaven approves it.
In Jesus' name.
Because that is what will push you to pray as though you have never prayed before.
From Friday the 25th of March through to Sunday the 3rd of April, 5 p.m. each night at Deliverance Outreach Ministries, 17 Argyle Avenue, Leighton, London, E107QE. Please call 07950-701-853 or 0207-923-2549 for more details. Be there.